Welcome to Samu't, Sari, Conversations with Mimi, a weekly podcast by Dino Social, also a member of the Guerrilla Podcast Syndicate. Samu't, Sari is where we can show that ordinary people do extraordinary things. Tune in to be entertained and to learn something new with your host, Mimi Lorilla.
Hello and welcome to Samu't, Sari Conversations with Mimi, a podcast featuring hot topics and other topics of interest for both men and women alike. Sometimes we feature guests who share their passion and commitment to their profession or talents. But on occasion, I'm here talking to you solo. This is just a casual conversation about stories to inspire you, stories from ordinary people who make extraordinary things. And in today's episode, I would like to talk about pursuing your passion, knowing the what, the why, and the how. So this is just a very simple conversation about why. Why do we need to focus on the passion? What is that passion all about? How will you discover it? And how are you going to go about pursuing that passion? And the reason why I've decided to do an episode around this topic is because we've had Jet Ramos recently, who talked about his different passions or his different achievements or his different activities. And that's born about his desire to be good at those different things. And he mentioned that it's always good to really be in touch with your inner self and think what it is that you'd really like to do. So today we will again revisit that, and we will discuss how we can pursue that passion. Okay, so in order for us to start this topic, pursuing your passion, know the what, the why, and the how, I guess I'll start with knowing exactly what that passion is. Okay, so what that passion is, it's very simple. It's simply knowing what you are good at and knowing what you are weak on or not so good at. So what's your weakness? What is your strength? So that's the first thing that you have to think about. So if I were to also do that for myself, what are my passions? What am I good at? And what are my weaknesses? I would probably start with the weakness. I'm not very good with computing or something that has to do with computers, programming, things like that, or analyzing data, anything that has to do with maths. That's not my area of interest, and that's not my area of specialty. So things like geometry, algebra, trigonometry, and even chemistry and physics, where there's an element of mathematics in there, I'm not really, really interested. It's an area that my husband really, really loves and is very good at that, so I leave all the math stuff to him. However, I'm very good at communicating. I'm very good with writing. I love reading, so I have good reading skills as well. I love doing research, and I obviously like to talk. So this is an area that my husband is not too good at or not comfortable. He can survive, he can do it, but he'd rather let me handle it. So we complement each other by knowing what we are good at and what we are not so good at. So that's what I mean. You have to know where you stand at the moment in terms of the skills that you feel strong about and those skills that you're probably not sure whether that's an area for you to further develop or an area for you to just set aside for now. So how do you know which ones are your good skills? So let's start with the basic five senses: sense of smell, touch, taste, hearing, and seeing. So why do we have to go back to the senses? They would tell you whether that would be an area of interest for you. For example, you like smelling things. Maybe you can combine that with the tasting things. So if you're very good in smelling and tasting things, maybe you're very good at cooking. You can probably be very good at cooking. For example, you like touching things. Maybe gardening is for you because it requires that you physically get your hands dirty, if you like, planting crops, vegetables, or pruning flowers. It's a very tactile activity, gardening. But if you love music, for example, you're probably very good in hearing. So maybe the musicality is in your blood and you know when it's a good song or when it's a song not a good song. If you're very good with seeing things, maybe you're very good in art. Okay, you can be a visual person determining what makes a good painting, for example, or a good photograph, the elements of a good photograph. So you start with what your senses tell you, and it sometimes guides you in determining which area you can go into, okay, as part of the senses. If not, you can go to the next level, which is to tap on the multiple intelligences. So when you tap on the multiple intelligences, you can talk about your analytical skills, your spatial skills, your sense of space, your musical skills, your language skills, and others. So I'm not going to mention specifically what the rest of the other multiple intelligences are, but you can easily research that online and see where your interests lie. Okay, the other thing, determining what is it that you're good at, sometimes people say, oh, find out that's something which runs in the family. So what is that something which runs in the family? Maybe there is a craft or a skill or a line of work that your family from generations to generations have been involved with, whether it's, for example, managing a company or managing a small business or maybe farming, or maybe you are all in the medical profession, or maybe you are in the legal profession, or maybe you are in the buy and sell profession. I don't know what profession it is. But if something runs in the family, maybe it's an area that you might be interested in. And maybe you can pursue that. And most likely, somebody more senior in the family will tell you, kailangan ipamana ko na to sa'yo. Ikaw na ang susunod na mamamahala nito. You will be the appointed future guardian of that business, or appointed as future person expected to continue on that business. So maybe you haven't thought about that, but now is a good time to ask your family members and see whether there is really indeed something that runs in the family that you might be interested in. So you can probably pursue that. Okay, so now that we know where we can tap those potential passion areas from, now is a good time to ask yourself that if you're good at something, how can you further advance that skill? Like, how are you going to develop that? So I have here some suggestions, which some of it I've done, some of it other people have done. So I'm not saying you should do all of it, but choose which areas you think you can, that best fits your situation. So for example, continuous learning. I consider myself a perennial student. Lagi po ako nag-aaral. I always try to learn something new. I never get tired of studying. And even my kids say, Mom, you're already too old to study. And I said to them, age is just a number. You're never too old to learn a new skill or to study. For example, doing the podcast, this is relatively new to me. I've been doing this for several months. And I know I have a lot more to learn in terms of my technical skills and knowledge and in terms of the way I do my podcast. But, you know, you have to start somewhere in order for you to continue to learn and grow. So continuous learning, I often enroll myself in different courses to gain more information and understanding about certain things related to my work. The other thing that you can do is seek advice from experts. So if you know that there's an expert in the family in business, running a business, why not seek advice from them? What are the tips? Okay, have some mentors. These are people who can coach you to do things properly. You can also observe how other people do it. If you don't want to have mentors at this stage or you're quite shy to seek advice from the experts, you can obviously learn from the way other people do it. So observe them, or you can maybe do a lot of Google, search them on YouTube and find out how other people do it as well. But the most important thing is don't get stuck with what you know. Yung what you think you already know, alam ko na yan, I don't need to know more. I don't think that's true, and that's a way of stopping yourself from growing further. Because as we all know, skills often develop over time. There are new ways of doing things. There are certain things that evolve through technology and through the advancement of knowledge itself. So maybe the way you've done things before are being done differently now. Or maybe what you know how it's done before isn't the way people do it now. I remember when I used to teach the basics of newspaper production, we often used a dummy copy of the newspaper by copy pasting everything that we typed, even the photos that we got out from the magazines, so we know where to place those articles from. But many years after that first time that I tried doing that same strategy with my students, we discovered there's actually a software in the computer that can allow you to lay out your articles and your photos. So we have MS Publisher and other types of software, even the simple Microsoft Word. So you don't need to do cut and paste, like literally cutting and pasting everything you type on a piece of paper, because that software saves you time, energy, and resources. So if I didn't learn that as I was teaching, I wouldn't have moved on from the archaic, old-fashioned way to the more modern and techie way of teaching my kids how to create their own newspaper dummy layout. So that is an example of don't get stuck with what you know, because there might be better ways of doing things than what you think. Okay, so what if you're not really so good at something? What do you do? That's the other question. So if you think that you're not good at something, okay, you can choose to defer pursuing that skill, okay? So you can choose to defer, maybe now is not the right time. Okay, so if that is not the right option for you, maybe you can study more to relearn this particular skill. So if you haven't done this for a while, maybe now is a good time to enroll in a course to refresh your mind or your knowledge, or to go from basic to the more advanced version of that something, whatever it is. Okay, so if you're still not sure if you want to defer or you really want to study more, maybe now is a time to have your skill assessed so you would know how and what else to improve. So skills assessment may come as a formal assessment. For example, if you go to an accreditation body or organization or a skills training institute, or maybe with an expert that you know, even if it's an informal assessment, yung something like, pakitingnan mo nga kung okay pa ako dyan sa skill na yan. Have another person review what you know to determine if you have the skills that are relevant and current to the time now, as opposed to the time that you have enrolled in this course before. And also self-assess and think about, do you really have the time to relearn this? Like, I have people telling me, is it okay if I study this and this and that? And then when they ask me to look at the curriculum or they ask me to go to a website and check it out for them, I can feel and I can say and I can assess that the skill that they wanted to relearn or to study on requires a lot of time and energy, which will probably require them to take time off work. So if you can afford to take time off work and focus on your studies, why not? But if you cannot do that and you're just inserting a little bit of your time to study in between your work and your family life, then it might be something that interferes with one of the other things that you're doing. So it might not be beneficial, maybe for yourself, but it might create issues with your work schedule, or maybe if your employer doesn't allow you to take time off to study, or it might suffer your time with your family or to focus on them. So finally, maybe instead of focusing on that particular skill that you think you want to do, maybe you're better off doing something else. So maybe in your mind, you're still thinking this is where you want to go, but in the reality of your current circumstance, maybe you're better off trying something new. So totally abandon that and assess what else you can do to help you out. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense, and hopefully that gives you an idea of, you know, thinking about what you are good at and what you are not so good at, and how do you determine whether to pursue that something that you are good at, or focus your attention to developing that aspect of the skill that you don't really want. For example, if I really want to learn how to do an Excel spreadsheet with formula, maybe I can do that. It's not a skill that I really, really like, and I'm very poor at that, but it will be a very steep learning curve for me to do that. So maybe I'll get the expert to do that for me rather than me doing it. So it just depends on what you think is the best for you. So now let's go to the why. Why do we need to pursue our passion? Why do we even care? Why are we even talking about this topic? So naturally, people have, as human beings, an inner desire to do something good. Okay, that's an innate human trait or a characteristic that we all share. If not an inner desire to do something good, we have an inner desire to express ourselves. So to communicate what we want to communicate, whether it's a verbal form, like now I'm sharing with you what I want to say, or it could be expressing in a different way. For example, through music, through arts, through dance. So communication is not just always verbal communication, but there are other ways of communicating ourselves. So painters, those famous painters or people who love art, communicate and express themselves through the visual medium. Okay, so that's one. The other reason why we want to pursue our passion or need to pursue our passion is because there is that desire to serve others or to share what we know. So one person asked me, what is the purpose of you doing Samu't, Sari, your podcast? Why are you doing this show when you can vlog about your everyday life? So my primary purpose for doing this podcast series is I have the desire to serve others by sharing insights and experiences of other people so they can learn from it, and to share what other people know about their own expertise or their passion and talents. And at the same time, I want to share what I know as well. So that's my driving force, why I'm into doing these podcasts here at Samu't, Sari. Then other people say that the reason why they pursue their passions is because it is a fulfillment of a purpose. For example, I don't know whether you know Brother Bo Sanchez. He's a preacher. He's also an entrepreneur. His fulfillment of a purpose to serve others and spread the word of God is his main reason for doing a lot of charitable works, forming a lot of organizations, for example, building the feast, which is, I think, worldwide. So that is his purpose that he knew from a young age. He keeps telling people about his desire to serve God even at a young age. So until now, he's doing that. So that's one of the ways by which we can discover the why we're doing it. Okay. And lastly, being true to ourselves. So we know what we like to do and what we're not good at something. And by being true to ourselves, we'll go with the path of where we're most familiar with, or where we can be most happy with. Okay, so I don't want to do Excel spreadsheets every day if I hated it. I want to do something that I really, really love and do it every day. And that will give me a reason to wake up each morning and be excited about the thought of being able to do what I like to do, rather than feel miserable every day thinking about doing a task or something that I don't really have the passion for. So that's going to drag my feet to accomplish and fulfill what I need to do. So that's what being true to yourself means. So now let's go to the how. We talked about the what, and we've talked about the why. Now we're going to the how of things. So the question is, what if you haven't found it yet? What if you haven't found that passion yet? What's the solution? Well, I have only two things to share. That is to keep looking and to keep trying. So keep looking. It's okay. It may be today until next month, you keep doing something which you think is the one, and then you ended up abandoning it because you realize that's not it. Then move to the next one. Move to the one that will lead you closer to that ultimate passion that you are still trying to discover. So when you keep looking, obviously you need to keep on trying. So if you fail today, it's okay. Then try again. Try until you succeed. Those are also nuggets of wisdom that I get from listening to coaches, to mentors, to the people that I follow, from people who are very experts in their field. These are the same things that they will tell you. And I found this to be true. That's why I'm sharing it. So keep looking and keep trying if you haven't found it yet. So let's go back to a previous episode where Jet Ramos was my guest. And I will use myself as well as a case study just to kind of further put forward the idea of pursuing a passion. So we all know based on that interview that Jet Ramos is very much into acting. Okay. He starred in some indie films, and he is passionate about getting more LGBTQ members of that community into acting as well, because they are still a minority in traditional film and cinema. So that's him. He's also into radio broadcasting. Nowadays, he really wants to inspire people through his radio show, and it focuses on interacting with teachers and sharing teaching strategies, tips, something around empowering them. And then he is obviously an education professional. He does workshops, seminars for teachers, and he also teaches in school. So he has a variety of students. He mentioned from young learners to adult education learners. He's got a wide span of experience being in the education field. So these are three kind of disjointed, not so much related areas of interest for Jet. So acting doesn't necessarily translate to radio broadcasting, doesn't necessarily translate into teaching, but he managed to combine the three. So I believe that these are the three passion areas of Jet. And this is the reason why I said I'd like to share this episode with you, because I am also an example of where my different interests kind of intersect into my life. So I am a teacher. I'm a piano teacher. I'm a music teacher. I am also indirectly consulting. So I'm an educational consultant. I used to be a teacher at a university. So I have a lot of my experience teaching more adult students. I'm also into music. I sing. I don't know whether you've heard about my music videos, but I've been singing since I was a little girl. I also play the piano. I'm doing podcasts now. I used to be like Jet. I started as a radio broadcaster, and when I moved to another country, I ended that stint. And when I became a teacher, a full-time teacher, I also ended my work as a broadcaster. So now going back to podcasting is my means of revisiting my love for broadcasting. I'm also very active in the not-for-profit charity work. So my job, my day job, has a lot to do with not-for-profit. But my experience being abroad helped me to set up a charity organization that helps Filipinos and other migrants in need. And I also love helping out in the community in whatever little way I can. Okay, through advising them, helping them with their CV, letter writing, and many other things. I focus more of my time now supporting my family, meaning as a mom to my kids and a wife to my husband. That is another area in my life that I am trying my best to be good at. I'm not perfect, nobody is, but I'm trying to be a very present person in their life, not just physically present, but you know, in almost every dimension of their lives, I try to be an active participant in that. I do love writing. I've published children's books, and I published an ebook recently. And I also am not a hoarder. I am a collector. I love collecting things. I have a piano collection, and I'm starting to collect fridge magnets as well. So my life is interesting. So maybe you see that I do a lot of things, but how do I manage to do that? Because if you really, really love something, you don't stop at that, and you don't make time as an excuse, but you try to budget your time in order for you to be able to move around in this certain areas of your life. And like I said, they don't really intersect all together at one time. There are aspects of my time that's more focused on the not-for-profit and family. Or maybe right now I'm into my podcast and music, not so much into my writing anymore because I published my book. But at one point in time, I was so focused on my writing, I can't do anything else because I want to focus on that. So it just depends on where you are in your life. So the next question is, okay, you seem to be perfect. You do a lot. You can't do it. How do you handle criticisms? What if there's a lot of people who try to put you down or to prevent you from succeeding, or who hate what you're doing, or that don't believe in your capacity to do it, or they lack the confidence in your ability to succeed in whatever it is? Okay, so let's try to take that elephant out of the room and really discuss this head on. So my response will be, so what? So what? They're not the ones investing their time, their energy, and their resources to that activity. You are doing it. So the least that they could do is support you. Yeah. On your part, you can also support them. So that's their opinion. So leave them to their own opinions. They're not the ones managing your life. So what you can do, instead of focusing on them, focus on your dream and focus on your goals. So this is what I'm doing right now. So if I see people criticizing me online for what I'm doing and what I'm not doing, even what I'm not doing, I'm being criticized for what I'm not doing, I'm still focusing on my dream and focusing on my goals. And I always think that there's no better time to try out new things but now. Now is relevant, because if you keep pushing it tomorrow, next day, the following year, it will never happen. But if you start somewhere now, then you would know if it's worth pursuing further or if you have to change your course and do something else. Remember when we talked about what we're good at, what we're not good at, how are we going to deal with it? So the point is, try it now. Even my husband and I tried to do online selling, like doing some e-commerce work. We were successful for a time, but we decided to defer that for now and focus on other things. But it's not to say that we will forever give up on that, but rather just set it aside for now. Let's park that for now because we have a different priority at this time of our lives. So the other advice for handling criticisms is, give yourself the time to learn and grow. Success is not achieved overnight. And the reason why you receive those criticisms is because people expect you to achieve right now, here, at this instant. And we all know that's impossible to do. And they know that it's impossible. And they want to see you fail. And you do not give them the opportunity to see you fail. But you want to give them an opportunity to see you grow, to see you continue to keep going, and obviously eventually to succeed. And that's where you should focus your efforts on. So the last bullet point that I have here is, stay on course. So the only way to succeed is stay on course, meaning whatever you decide to do, whether you move left, right, center, just stay on that course. So I think that ends our episode for today about pursuing our passion, the what, the way, the why, and the how. And I hope it further inspired you to go back and revisit that something that you really, really want to do. that you probably are postponing, or you're probably just thinking at the back of your mind, but you're not actively doing anything to kickstart it, or maybe you just need some few pointers on how to start something. So for more information about this episode, or if you need me to help you out with something, or you just simply want to have an offline conversation with me about this topic, please reach out to Mimi at dinosocial.com. And I really, really would appreciate it if you don't forget to like. So please, 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 please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more Samu't Sari episodes. The more subscribers I get for my channel, the more people I can serve. So I'm thankful for those who have subscribed. My dear subscribers, thank you. They keep growing. So I do really appreciate you for obviously appreciating the show. And please share my videos so that more people can view it and more people can benefit from the information that we are providing to them. So thank you. That's it from me. I would like to also plug the other shows of the Gorilla Podcast Syndicate. Samu't Sari is a member of the Gorilla Podcast. Reach out to me via my Facebook page and my Twitter account. Just search for Mimi Laurilia and you will find me. And please also check out the other programs of the Gorilla Podcast. So with this, I end this episode. And again, thank you so much for being here. And I hope to see you in a future episode. Stay true to yourself and pursue your passion. Bye for now.
If you find value in this episode, make sure you like and subscribe to be notified of new releases. If you have any questions or suggestions, please reach out to Gorilla Podcast or send us an email at mimi@dinosocial.com. Spread the word and don't forget to tune in next time.